In this tutorial, we will show you two approaches to merging a batch of sources into one target file. In both approaches, we will sort our data in ascending order. Both approaches feature the same source files that are based on the same JSON schema called books. Each JSON file represents a collection of books of a particular genre. Even though there is only one source component in each mapping, each component reads data from a batch of JSON files. Both mappings also have the same target schema called publications. In the first approach, our goal is to read files that match a wildcard. All the files are located in the same folder. This simple and effective solution to reading a batch of files is especially convenient when you want to process files matching a particular pattern in a directory. In the second approach, our source component has a dynamic node that accepts file names from a separate text file. This method is beneficial when you have a list of files to process, and the actual files may be stored in a different location, separately from the mapping design, and possibly with additional data that you may want to map to the output. As a result of both approaches, all the JSON files will be merged into one single XML file, with the book IDs sorted in ascending order. Let's start with the first approach. We will first add our source component to the mapping. At this stage, we won't supply any instance files. Now we need to open the component settings to configure the wildcard. And then we will supply the following path to the input JSON file field. The wildcard instructs MapForce to look for JSON files, and these JSON files can have anything after the book list prefix. Since this is our source component, the output file is not needed, and we can simply delete it from the component settings. The next step is to add our target XSD schema to the mapping. Now let's connect the source and target nodes. Let's take a look at the output. Since our book records come from different files, the book IDs are all jumbled up. That's why we need a sort component on the connection between the object and the publication element. To add a sort component, we will right-click this connection and then select Insert Sort from the context menu. The sorting criterion is the book ID node. The book IDs will be sorted in ascending order. Let's check the output. We can see that all our publications are nicely organized. The starting point of the second approach is the previous mapping. However, there is something we need to tweak in the source component. Instead of using the wildcard, we will make the file node dynamic. To make the node dynamic, we will click the File String button and then select Use Dynamic File Names from the list. The file node is now dynamic and mappable. For this mapping, we have a separate text file that contains a list of file names, so let's add this text file to the mapping. The next step is to import the input file. As soon as we import the file, its values appear in the bottom part of the component settings. Our text component will have only one node called File. When we click OK, MapForce suggests changing the component name or leaving the default name. We would like to change the component name. In our example, the book list files in the mapping design are located in different folders. Then how do we get the right file paths? For this purpose, we will use one of the file path functions called resolveFilePath. Let's double-click the empty area, start typing the name of the function, and then double-click the function. The next step is to connect the file field with the file path parameter of the function. The base folder is the path against which the file names will be resolved. Let's add a constant and supply the path at which the booklist files are located. We'll double-click the empty area and type the following string with a double quotation mark in front of it. Then press Enter. This path will be used as the base folder. And now we need to connect the result of the function to the dynamic node. Let's see the output. As you can see, all the publications have been merged into a single XML file. You can test all the MapForce features yourself. Simply download a fully featured 30-day free trial from the Litova website.